Got nitric oxide? Well, if you have asthma or high blood pressure, you might not have enough, and this video is for you. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and you're watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk a bit about nitric oxide. Now, in the last several videos, I've been using the StrateGene report. Find the link in the description for how to order it if you're unfamiliar with it. You can see on my StrateGene report that there are mutations for NOS3, also called ENOS. You can see that I'm heterozygous for one of them and the other one. These ENOS mutations mean that I'm a little bit less efficient at making nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is something that helps you dilate your blood vessels. And if you don't have enough of it, it predisposes you to cardiovascular disease, and it may cause high blood pressure. But it's also the case that nitric oxide combines with another awesome molecule called glutathione in your lungs. And there, it produces something called nitrosoglutathione. Nitrosoglutathione is your endogenous bronchodilator. Bronchodilators are what are given to asthmatics because people with asthma do not have enough nitrosoglutathione, their own bronchodilator. When an asthma attack occurs that is so severe it puts someone in the hospital, the nitrosoglutathione levels in the lungs drop nearly to zero. Asthma is essentially a condition of deficient nitrosoglutathione. Now, glutathione supplementation can be very helpful for asthma, but I have a consulting client who tried glutathione and got a little bit of benefit from it, but it didn't help that much on its own. Then she started taking a product called Neo40, and I'll put a link in the description of this video, but Neo40 is a product that is meant to increase your levels of nitric oxide. All of a sudden, she started getting a lot of benefit to her asthma from that. Then we looked at her StrateGene report, and sure enough, she had the same ENOS mutations that I have, so she has a genetically decreased ability to make nitric oxide. So if you have this, you want to consider a few things. First of all, this enzyme depends on zinc. So you want to make sure that your diet is not deficient in zinc, and you can measure your plasma levels of zinc to make sure they're at least 75, ideally 100 to 120, and that they're not any lower than 75, in which case that zinc could be hurting this enzyme. It can also be helpful to get a plasma amino acid analysis and see if your arginine levels are normal. If they're on the low side of normal or they're really low, that could hurt the activity of this enzyme simply because this enzyme uses arginine to make nitric oxide. Number three, if you have genetically decreased levels of this enzyme, those things might not matter as much in the sense that you can't add any extra zinc or any extra arginine to make up for the low levels of this enzyme. You just want to make sure that you're not getting kicked in the face twice, so to speak, with the deficiencies and the lower levels of the enzyme. You probably will benefit from ways that get around the enzyme to increase the amount of nitric oxide production. One way to do that is to eat a diet that is very rich in a diverse array of vegetables. These vegetables can have natural nitrates that generate nitric oxide without this enzyme. I think a simple rule of thumb is try eating the large bulk of your diet, the volume, eat most of that as vegetables and see if it improves your health. Then if even that doesn't work, or for digestive reasons or other reasons, it's just not feasible to eat that volume of vegetables for you, or if you just need to add extra strategies to try to improve your asthma or your high blood pressure, your cardiovascular risk, try the product Neo40. Again, I'll put the link in the comments. Try the product Neo40 to see if that helps, because that might be a supplemental way to get your nitric oxide levels higher. If you feel great, you don't have high blood pressure, you don't have any signs of cardiovascular risk, you don't have asthma, then I don't think it matters if you have these mutations. It might be that you're just eating a diet that gives you everything you need, and the little bit lower activity of the enzyme doesn't matter. But it's when you have problems that sound plausibly related to nitric oxide that you want to start implementing these strategies. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of ChrisMasterjohnPhD.com. You've been watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.